Carla from ReQtest, and today we're going to discuss how to write a useful bug report. Useful bug reports help get bugs fixed, and a useful bug report will have two qualities. One, that it is reproducible, and two, that it is specific. Let's explain these two a little bit more. A bug report has to be reproducible, because if an engineer can't find the bug and prove that it exists, it will probably be labeled as invalid. Every relevant detail you can provide will help to reproduce the bug, which is what the engineer needs to be able to solve the bug. Secondly, a bug report needs to be specific. The faster the engineer can isolate the issue to a specific problem, the more likely it is for the bug to be fixed right away. Now let's show a bad bug report and compare it to a good one. Okay, so here's the bad bug report. My browser crashed. I think it was on ReQtest.com. I really think that it's a bad problem and you should fix it, or nobody else will use your website. Also, my friends all think your icons are ugly. One of them is a designer. Maybe he can help you. Oh, and my boss says the layout of ReQtest on his computer is really bad. And this is the good one. My PC crashes each time I try to upload a screenshot to a requirement. I'm using Mozilla Firefox on a Windows 7 Ultimate Service Pack 1 system. The build ID is 2000609. Firefox crashed each time I clicked the Browse button to choose a file to upload to ReQtest. That's quite a bit of detail, isn't it? But it's all very relevant info for the tester. When writing a bug report, always try to think of the person who is going to fix the bug. Consider what information is vital and what info is completely redundant. Well, that's all for this video, and I'll see you next time.